features the world's rarest Hemi-powered car. Now, when I say that, what do you think of? Daytona, Superbird, Plymouth, maybe a Cuda? What if I was to tell you that the world's rarest Hemi in the world is in a Coronet? Yes. 1966 Dodge Coronet 426 Hemi, one of four made. Now, wait a minute. You're saying, what's so rare about that? Look at this. It's a four-door Hemi. Four-door. Only four were made. Two Euro cars and two American cars. This is one of the American cars made. Four-door with a 426 Hemi. Now, hang on. I think I know where the other one is. There's only two. Here's one. I know where the other one is, and I am going to get it for you. Only on Muscle Car Madness. I found that car, and here it is. Now, the story isn't about the car, but who owns this number two Hemi? You remember I told you there was only four made. This is the rarest Hemi in the world. Four-door Hemi, only four made, two Euros and two Americans. This is the second one. Now, the story goes that in Miami, Florida, there's an athlete down there that plays for the Heat that calls himself the Daddy. Now, we know who we're talking about. But in the world that we live in, there is only one Daddy. That's the owner of this car, and here he is right here. Big Daddy Don Garlits owns the second rarest Hemi in the world. Big Daddy, welcome to the program.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Glad to be here.
Now, tell us about this particular car. How did you come about getting it, and how long have you had it?
Well, it was an ad in Hemings. I'd heard about the car. I'd heard there were two of them. You say there's four. I guess two in Canada. Is that it?
Two in Europe.
I've never seen those. And they say it's not as documented as this is. But anyway, they were both in the Hemings the same month for sale. So I sent a deposit on both of them. And I picked up this one first. And when I went to get the second one, the guy returned my deposit. I guess he'd heard that the cars were worth more than what it was. He was only asking $6,000 for the second car, which was a basket case. This car was all together. It's never been apart. It's just been repainted. Mm-hmm. It's basically original. So I like this one the best. That's why I got it first. Mm-hmm. And anyway, I brought it back here about 15 years ago, and then we, like I say, we repainted it because it was kind of scratched up. It was just used every day, and he told me it was a FBI car, and I just kind of laughed about that, you know. But when we took it apart, took the door panels off and did some straightening on the doors, there were Treasury Department papers in one of the doors, the rear doors. Yeah. So they must have had that in there, so in case the car got stolen or something, it'd be real easy to find, you know, if they changed the numbers or yeah. something. Mm-hmm. And so, anyway, all the build sheet and everything was under the spring in the back seat. It was all there. And it's a kind of a fun car. And then the second one, the guy that got it went to New York and was restored and went through auction at $60,000. And last year, the guy that has that car now or had it at that time called me up and wanted to know if I wanted to sell this one. And I said, no. I said, I wouldn't take $1 million for it because it's very rare and it belongs in this museum. And he said, well, that's what I had in mind offering you for it. He evidently had a sale for the car over in the Middle East for $1.5 million, and he was going to buy mine, look at both of them, decide which one he wanted to keep, sell the other one to the Middle Eastern guy, but it didn't happen. And then you just told me that he turned down $800,000 yes, at an auction yep. recently, which I don't blame him. I wouldn't take $800,000 for it.